The dhyanas and the absorptions of the Buddha are perfected. Prajnaskanda. Furthermore, the wisdom aggregate is perfected in the Buddha. From the first production of the mind of Bodhi and during incalculable periods, there is no dharma that he has not practiced. From existence to existence, he has accumulated qualities. Mindful and resolute, he sacrificed his life to find wisdom, as was the case for the Bodhisattva Satipaluan. Furthermore, as he has cultivated great compassion and wisdom, the Buddha has perfected the wisdom aggregate. Other people do not have this great compassion, and even if they do have wisdom, they do not perfect great compassion. Wanting to save beings and seeking all kinds of wisdoms, the Buddha has destroyed even his attachment to the Dharma and suppressed the 62 kinds of wrong view. He does not fall into the pairs of extremes. A life attached to the five objects of enjoyment and pleasure or a life of personal mortification. Nihilism or eternalism, existence or non-existence, and other extremes of this kind. Furthermore, the Buddha's wisdom is peerless and his penetration without equal, for they are all the result of very deep concentrations and are not disturbed by coarse or subtle emotions. He practices well the 32 auxiliaries to enlightenment, the 4 trances, the 4 formless absorptions, the 8 liberations, the 9 successive absorptions and the other qualities. He possesses the 10 strengths, the 4 fearlessnesses, the 4 unhindered knowledges, and the 18 special attributes. He has obtained the unhindered and inconceivable liberations. This is why the wisdom aggregate of the Buddha is perfected. Furthermore, the Buddha has vanquished the great heretical scholars, namely Yoliopinlikya Cho, Mohokya Cho, Mahakasyapa, Cho Lifu, Mokin Lin, Sashonikin Tsu, Poso Cheo Lo, Chiang Tchao, etc. The Buddha vanquished all these great scholars. This is why we know that his wisdom aggregate is perfected. Furthermore, in the 3 baskets, the 12 classes of texts and the 84,000 articles of the Dharma, we see how numerous were the words of the Buddha. This is why we know that his wisdom also is great. Thus, Avisya, seeing at dawn a place where there had been a lot of rain, said to the people, "Last night the power of the rain dragon was very great." The people asked him, "How do you know?" He answered, "I see that the ground is damp, the mud abundant, the mountain collapsed, the trees knocked down and the animals killed. That is how I know that the power of the dragon was great." It is the same for the Buddha. Although his profound wisdom is not visible to the eye, it makes the mighty rain of the Dharma rain down. He vanquishes the great scholars like the kings of the gods Sakra and Brahma. This is why it is possible to know that the Buddha's wisdom is great. Furthermore, as the Buddhas have acquired the unhindered liberations over everything, their wisdom is unhindered. Furthermore, this wisdom of the Buddha is completely pure and surpasses all ordinary analysis. He does not see any nature in dharmas that is eternal or non-eternal. Finite or infinite, mobile or immobile, existent or non-existent, impure or pure, conditioned or unconditioned, arising and perishing or non-arising, non-perishing, empty or non-empty. The eternal purity of dharmas is immense like space. This is why his wisdom is unhindered. Those who see arising and cessation in dharmas cannot see non-arising and non-cessation in them. Those who see non-arising and non-cessation in dharmas cannot see arising and cessation in them. If non-arising and non-cessation are real, then arising and cessation are false. If arising and cessation are real, non-arising and non-cessation are false. It is the same for all analyses of this type. As the Buddha has unhindered wisdom on this subject, we know that his wisdom is perfected. Vimuktiskanda. Furthermore, one recollects the perfection of the deliverance skanda in the Buddha. The Buddha is free from all the disturbing emotions and their traces. As he has uprooted them, his deliverance is real and indestructible. Since he is endowed with omniscience, it is unhindered deliverance. Since he has the 8 liberations and these are profound and universal, it is complete deliverance. Furthermore, since the Buddha has left the lower stages of those who are liberated by chance and those liberated by wisdom, he realizes the twofold deliverance perfectly. As he has these two deliverances, it is perfected deliverance aggregate. Furthermore, the Buddha has obtained deliverance because he has destroyed Mara's armies, eliminated the negative emotions, rejected the dhyana systems, and also because he enters into and comes out of samadhi supremely and without obstacle. Finally, in the path of seeing the truths, the bodhisattva attained 16 profound deliverances. The second vimukti was an unconditioned deliverance resulting from the abandonment of the 10 fetters relating to the suffering of kamdhatu, commonly called dukkhi dharmajnana, and so on up to the 16th vimukti called marjanvijnana. Then, in the path of meditation, the bodhisattva obtained 18 deliverances. The second vimukti was an unconditioned deliverance resulting from the abandonment of the 3 fetters to meditation in arupiya dhatu, and so on up to the 18th vimukti, where there is a conditioned deliverance associated with the destruction of the impurities and an unconditioned deliverance resulting from the abandonment of all the fetters. These two deliverances together constitute the perfection of the deliverance aggregate. Closing parenthesis. Vimuktijnanadarsanaskanda. Furthermore, one recollects the perfection of the aggregate of the Buddha called knowledge and seeing deliverance. This aggregate is of two types. In regard to emancipation from his disturbing emotions, the Buddha puts the knowledge of destruction of the impurities to